Yes.
Now make yourself useful. And the first part of useful is not driving me insane with your constant complaining.
I ain't complaining.
You are! Complain!
I ain't complaining, I'm just saying.
You're not saying, miss. You're shouting!
Oh, I'm sorry, Captain. Did they do things differently in the Navy?
Yeah, they left the ladies in port.
Oh, say whatever you damn well please, but I tell you, if I don't get out of here soon, I'm gonna kill somebody.
And if you don't stop hissing at me, I'm gonna... What is wrong with you two?
I ain't chopping vegetables for a living.
Oh, I'm sorry, man. Was there insufficient feathers?
Oh, this is the one that they saved.
Mr. Morgan, I'll work, but not this.
Well, I cooking work?
My husband and I, we shared the work. All of it. I was out in the fields. I can hunt, carry a knife, or use a gun. But I tell you, you keep me here, I'll skin this fat old coot and serve him for dinner!
Watch your damn mouth, you crazy goddamn fishwife!
Enough, both of you!
Jeez.
Come with me then. Wanna head out there? Run with the man? So be it. But we do more than just hunting. We're hunted. And them things hunting us, well, they got guns of their own.
I ain't afraid of dying.
Good. You need anything, Mr. Pearson? Maybe me and Miss Zad are gonna take a little ride.
Yeah, sure. Here's my list, and can you post this letter for me while you're there?
Sure. Come on, princess. Are you coming with me then, woman?
Jeez.
So I've graduated from chopping vegetables to shopping?
Shut your goddamn mouth.
Damn! What's up, Jeremy Hillicollin? How are you guys?
You cool down then yet?
I guess. But I ain't no scullion. And I sure as hell ain't taking orders from that sweating halfwit.
I guess we all gotta do our share, princess.
Where's the letter?
You reading his mail now?
Oh, robbing and killing's okay, but letter reading's where we draw the line.
Mm. Yep.
Here.
I'm good. Thanks for asking.
Dear Aunt Kathy.
You are something else.
I haven't heard from you in some time, so I pray to the Lord above that your health has not deteriorated further. Blah, blah, blah.
Ooh, what's that rock?
Wait a sec. Listen to this. Since we last corresponded, I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself. Before you ask, I am still yet to take a wife, but I can assure you it's not for a lack of suitors. He ever actually even...
It's messed up, dog. Good morning, funny boy. Good morning. It's me on Discord. And hello, Tony. How are you?
And what's this? Return to Tacitus Kilgore.
Oh, that's Dutch's idea. All male to be sent to the same aliens. Whenever we set up somewhere new, Strauss, he heads into town. Doesn't the start expecting mail from a Tacitus Kilgore, whatever they changed it to. Here, give me that back. We got work to do. Okay, here we are.
So, what's the plan? I shoot the shopkeeper while you...
Phoenix Mother Trucker Feather.
I thought we was outlaws.
You see, you got Red Dead Redemption 2. Is it funny? It's awesome.
We rob fools and rob other people. These people, they're just trying to get by. So you head on in there and you buy some food to eat. No guns.
You're sure?
This time, there'll be time for killing soon enough.
What are you doing?
I'm gonna go check the mail. Nothing exciting.
Is that a train? Sounded like it was coming right through here. Must be coming through there. Yep. What do you mean nothing? What's in the parcel? What's up, my dude?
Can I help you, mister?
Yes, I would like to post a letter.
All right. Okay, no trouble.
Thank you.
Bye now.
Bye. Witness protection. That's an old movie, dude. She got the hookup.
I think this is everything.
Thanks. Here. Take that for yourself, okay?
Thanks.
Well, give it back then. Jesus. I didn't ask for his goddamn help.
Why don't you drive?
Okay.
Come on, lady. Get a move on.
I like Sadie, not lady.
I know.
She got her wardrobe changed.
I think so.
And some new clothes, I see.
Don't start. I can wear what I damn well want. Like I told you, my husband and I shared all the work. I wasn't some little wife with a flower in her hair baking cherry pies all day.
Yeah, I don't doubt that. You sure look the part now. Won't be long before you're smoking cigars and playing the harmonica.
Have you know, I used to love playing the harmonica before. Well, my house and everything I own got burned to the ground.
I know. I'm real sorry about what you know. Maybe I'll keep my eye out for another one.
I don't want no pity. Just treat me equal and know. Nobody's taking nothing from me ever again.
Damn.
Just don't kill the camp cook. Please.
Hey there!
Hey.
What you folks up to?
Just heading home.
You're in Lemoyne Raider country.
Keep it cool, Steve.
You need to pay a toll to pass through here.
No, I don't think so.
You don't think so? How about you pull over right now?
Pull over?
That's what I said.
Hey, how's about this?
Go! Go, go, go!
God damn it! Get me down! Whoa! What the hell was that?
They was gonna rob us.
New pair of pants. Take your landing records.
Oh, shoot! I'm gonna run this son of a bitch down.
Oh, damn! You know what? Screw this. Where are you at? I'm looting first. love me some loot. Yeah, get that all that random crap we can throw in the box. Yeah, online coming out later this month. Well, the beta's coming out later this month. They didn't say the full release. Depends on how the beta goes. Wait, what is it? Drop? Or, we'll do that. That's the. Wait, what? There it is. I got my other one, right? The one I bought. Yeah, okay. I need to clean my weapons. And there's one last guy over here. Guess he's got nothing to loot.
No, pass those reins here.
Why?
Because you've caused enough trouble already.
I'm fine.
Yep.
We showed those bastards, huh?
Remind me not to get on your bad side.
And they was clearly planning to bushwhack us.
You did good. But that's a lot of mess to make near camp. Hope it don't bring anyone sniffing around.
Are you gonna tell Dutch?
Maybe. If he asks. But maybe not.
Careful now. So who did they say they were? Lemoyne Raiders?
Lemoyne Raiders.
Yeah, something like that. Who knows? Anyway, don't you go ribbing Pierce about that letter.
Dare you? I wouldn't dream of it.
Right, you wouldn't.
I have traveled widely, making no small name for myself.
I won't be giving you no mail to post anytime soon, that's for sure.
I just want to peek in that journal of yours. The mind boggles.
Not a chance.
You didn't get yourself killed then, Miss Adler.
Not quite.
Well, I'd like to say I missed your refined conversation, but I'd be lying.
I enjoyed myself out there.
Yes, we, Mrs. Adler did okay.
At shopping?
Yes, at shopping.
Thank you, Mr. Morgan.
Don't mention it. I would ride with you again, Mrs. Adler, if you will ride with me.
Maybe. If you prove you can handle yourself.
Well, they say I lack finesse, but I ain't afraid of gun smoke.
We got this, Arthur. You've already done me a big favor today. Okay, Miss High and Mighty. And nice pants, by the way.
You want to die, dude.
You're
all
always right. Bumping into stuff.
Who called my name?
Next time we run an errand together, remind me to pack more bullets.
Come on, Arthur. Don't pretend that wasn't kind of fun.
How are you, Miss Karen?
Fine. How are you, Mr. Bill?
Good. Heard you said something to
somebody called my name over here. I'm guessing it's over here. I really do, though, need to clean my gun. Stamina, health tonic, provisions, clothes, crafting, hunting.
So, Arthur,
Is it true about the bad luck?
What bad luck?
JT, thank you for the 500 cheer, man. Much appreciated. Hello, Casey. How are you?
We won't see 7 years out. Don't be ridiculous. But if I find a mirror on my adventures, I'll bring it back for you.
Thank you, Arthur.
So I need a mirror and I need a harmonica. What's the black dots for? Chopping firewood? Oh, this should be interesting. Magic lantern show? If I'm going to go out with you, I'm going to have to look my best. Can I borrow $10? Now the black dots was a chore. I didn't know that. See, it's gone now.
How you doing, old friend? It's funny, us ending up down here. My daddy died in a field in Pennsylvania, fighting this lot. I ever tell you that?
Many times. See, I'm boring you, Arthur. Worrying me. We lost men back there.
We have lofty goals, Arthur. We're trying to reform society to a kinder, truer, better way. Now, of course, there's gonna be casualties.
Damn.
Thieves. You know, a world that don't want us no more.
We are dreamers in an ever duller world of fact. Now, I'll give you one, but come on. We got the day. It's nice out.
Old Jose says that there's a trick around here. I reckon it's full of fish.
Oh, God. Fishing again. Didn't catch anything last time.
Show us this crick you've been pissing in.
Hey, you don't look too rosy, old friend. I thought this warmer weather would...
My days are looking good along, old Dutch.
Always dream crushing and bubble bursting.
Come on, Jose. Let's go.
Come on, then.
Why we ran slow.
Behind you. Go on. Why don't we just fish here? Old lake of them. I need to get out for a bit. Me and the old guard. Before any of them back there, it was us.
The curious couple and their unruly son.
It feels good here. You did well finding that spot, Arthur.
More Charles than me.
It's like I can breathe again, thick and soupy as this air is. Might even do your whistling pipes some good, Hosea.
I was once in this country with Bessie. Feels like a lifetime ago.
It was a lifetime ago. But what a life we have lived, how well we have fought, especially both of you.
I hope so.
But now, when things are desperate, we have to stick with the plan. Make enough money, then find somewhere where nobody will find us. But we don't have to hide.
Like where?
Yeah, like where?
Ideas hatching, but I need you with me, not against me. Both of you.
Of course.
Still, we do need money.
Oh my god, dude. I'd have to pay $300 for your new damn tent.
After Valentine, I want everyone on best behavior here. No trouble.
Uh-oh.
Start turning over the soil and the rocks. See what turns up.
Dutch, we've got to be discreet.
Imagine what a slew of rich simpletons there must be down here. Oh, this is perfect for you, Hosea. You'll be able to play them like a fiddle.
Nothing would give me greater pleasure, but
no buts. Not today. We fish and we enjoy the day. Looks like law up ahead. Play it cool.
Hello, gentlemen. Well, look what the cat drug in. I seem to have gotten myself in a spot of bother.
Quiet back there.
Let's see if we can't sort this out.
Well, well, look who it is.
How are you, boys?
Fine.
This is quite
the guy I've been looking for.
You have here.
We like it well enough.
Hoagie McIntosh, at your service.
Lee Gray, this is my deputy Archibald McGregor.
It's good to meet
you. Oh, God, it's Connor.
You a Scot?
Partly. The best.
Of course.
Now, tell me, sir, what did the silly fancy fop back there do? Nothing too terrible, I trust.
He was accused of running a gold mining investment scam.
Oh, no. I'm sure he wasn't. He is a magician. I know him. He's a fool. But he is not a bad fellow. Now, can we just...
I wouldn't do that if I were you.
Shit! The Anderson boys! I can't have more scandal!
Well, allow us to help, my friend. Arthur!
Chase wanted man.
And take Archibald with you.
Just what I signed up for. Come on, big guy.
Perhaps we can discuss the foolish magician.
Stay with that train. Don't let them get away. And do not
shoot. Oh, there's
Cal. You hear me? Come on, hurry.
All right.
Come on, we're losing them.
Will you relax? We're not losing them.
Faster, come on.
Go as fast as I can.
Arthur Callahan.
Faster, Mr. Callahan, please. My neck is on the line here.
I get it. I'm doing my best. So what are these fellas wanted for? Looks like a son of a bitch is gonna make. You sure I can't just shoot him?
No. Did I not say that?
You said plenty.
Look at you two fellas all cuddled up.
Oh, that was good shit.
You think you can jump on there?
Me? Why me?
Because you ride like my grandmother.
You are something else. You dumb bastards. I didn't do nothing.
There's two.
Run, don't let them get away.
What do you think I'm doing?
You hold it right there.
Where are they gonna get away on a train at? I got. Give me a second. All right. Sorry about that. All right. Where's my hat? Not till after I pick up my hat. Yeah, let me pick my damn hat.
I don't think he's dead. I think I won the fight. Oh, just about.
Bring him out here.
Casey, thank you for the host. Hello, Delaware Game, Andy. Anderson.
Take him in. Come on. A fine job. Well done. And a pat on the back for me for stopping the train. Load Anders onto the back of your horse there, and we'll take him to Sheriff Gray. There you go. You are a natural.
You are a natural. Let's take him in.
Follow me. What about the others?
Oh, we'll round them up. Anders back there is the brains of the operation, and that's really saying something.
You're the boss.
That was mighty impressive, sir. I have to admit. I'd hazard a guess you've served the law yourself at some point.
Well, I wouldn't exactly say that.
Are you familiar with the area here?
No, not really.
On your right here, these tobacco fields? This is part of Caliga Hall, big estate belonging to the Gray family.
Looks bone dry.
Yes,
and my family?
In dire need of some rain round here, let me tell you. The Grays have lived in Caliga Hall for generations. Fine people. My family's been working for them for years. Sheriff Gray's the one I know best, of course, but they own half the business.
Oh, Ethan, how are you?
Which town?
Rhodes, sir. You don't know it? Where we're headed right now. Ain't what it was before the war, but it has its charms. I'm sure you already know of the Braithwaites.
Braithwaites?
Just got down here.
Another big family in these parts. They have an estate west of here. Awful people, truly awful. They've been fighting with the Grays for as long as I can
remember. Oh, good lord. Half-Hill McCoys.
Like quite the place you got here.
We're gonna bear left here.
Good, how you looking right there? I'm loving it. I love this game.